Bombshell dropped in Vegas massacre months later, this is really bad. This is just unbelievable and just plain baffling to any thinking person. Today the chief of the Las Vegas office of the FBI said he expects the agency to release a report on the October 1st massacre before the tragedy's first anniversary. What? Almost a whole year later and they still probably won't be sure as to wipe out a quint postal on a group of innocent concert-goers in Las Vegas? Aaron Rouse, a special agent for the FBI that's in charge of this case, added that they know very well that's a long time for some people, but that speaking for the FBI, that's actually considered to be light speed. Keep in mind that this is the same FBI that's wasting millions of our hard-earned tax dollars trying to come up with anything they can conjure up about our president and the fake Russian collusion narrative which the Democrat Party and the crooked Hillary Clinton campaign made up in order to justify the fact that no one wanted her as their president and she ran a piss-poor campaign. Via Fox News. Las Vegas shooting, FBI official says info on motive may take until next October to release. Want to finally know why Stephen Paddock gunned down 58 people in Las Vegas in early October? Be prepared to wait a while, possibly until next October, the chief of the FBI's Las Vegas office revealed this week during an interview in which he said the agency probably wouldn't brief the public until their report is released sometime before the tragedy's first anniversary. Now that's a long time for some people, but speaking for the FBI, that's light speed, all right? Special Agent in Charge Aaron Rouse told the Las Vegas Review-Journal on Wednesday. Rouse said reports from other agencies investigating the mass shooting will be released at different times, but the FBI's one is focusing a large part on the why, which is what everybody wants to know. File. In this October 3, 2017, file photo. Personal belongings and debris litters the Route 91 Harvest Festival grounds across the street from the Mandalay Bay Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. A plan that will be used to divide donations to victims of the Las Vegas mass shooting includes a provision to assist those who sought medical attention but weren't hospitalized. The committee overseeing the distribution of more than $22 million released the final plan Friday, December 15. It was revised in response to requests that money also go to victims who didn't require a hospital stay. AP photo, Marshal Jose Sanchez, file. In this October 3, 2017, file photo, personal belongings and debris litters the Route 91 Harvest Festival grounds across the street from the Mandalay Bay Resort and Casino in Las Vegas. AP. That burning question has not been answered, but Rouse said evidence still suggests Paddock was the only person involved in the attack and that he has not been linked with any affiliations or ideologies. The FBI previously denied claims by the Islamic State that Paddock was responding to a call to intensify attacks against Western countries bombing its territories in Syria and Iraq. Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department Sheriff Joe Lombardo has said in the past that Paddock's mounting gambling losses may have played a role. As I sit here today, I believe that we are learning as much as we possibly can about why the subject did what they did, Rouse said. Las Vegas shooting victims all died of gunshot wounds, coroner's report finds. Rouse told the Las Vegas Review-Journal that the FBI has interviewed around 400 people worldwide in connection to Paddock and has brought in the same number of specialists to help document evidence. He said the Route 91 Harvest Music Festival site took investigators 14 days to come over, while Paddock's room and hotel hallway at the Mandalay Bay Resort and Casino took 13. Important items found at both sites have been sent to the FBI's central lab in Virginia. We're going to have, I think, the best digital schematic of what happened and where it happened and how it happened that you can come up with, Rouse said. He added that FBI investigators have 22,000 hours of surveillance and cell phone footage and 250,000 photos to look over, amounting to about 40 terabytes of data. We didn't leave anything uncovered, Rouse told the Las Vegas Review-Journal. And again, the casinos, with their support, let us track down a lot of information of who may have had contact with that person. And it was very helpful to us. So let's sum this whole mess up. A man who's very well off financially, and who had never demonstrated any mental health issues, all of a sudden decides to go postal on a group of concert goers, and it will take the FBI what will probably be years to get to the bottom of the reasons why. This awful crime was planned months ahead of time and it was carried out without a hitch, but the FBI is going to take that long to even guess at giving us a motive? I'm not much of a conspiracy theorist, but maybe they want to stall this as long as possible because they are hoping people will forget. After all, it was only a bunch of country music fans, right? Obama's FBI? Please share if you want to see the FBI disbanded and replaced with an organization that works for the people.